So you want a budget smartphone, but you want a name brand. Well, I'm gonna check out the Samsung J3 Luna Pro right after this. And for all you new people, welcome. My name is Travis and I do tech videos every single week and I have a blast doing them. If that sounds fun to you, sit back, relax, and enjoy yourself. All the products I talk about will be in the description below. But for now, let's get into the video. Once upon a time, all smartphones cost about $1,000. But that's not the case anymore. And as a matter of fact, you can get a really good smartphone for under $100. There's a bunch of manufacturers that have made a name being budget. I mean, like Blue and Huawei, and there's a bunch of companies out there that do that very thing. But what happens when one of the biggest manufacturers of smartphones makes a budget smartphone? Well, let's see what Samsung can do. Let's unbox it. The Samsung J3 Luna Pro. On a side note, I've actually filmed this more than once. As a matter of fact, I was gonna try to do something special for this. I shot a bunch of footage outside. I even got some aerial footage. I had all different types of ideas. I thought it was gonna be really cool. But upon watching the footage, I changed my mind. So here we are. So what is the Luna J3 Pro? Well, it's a phone by Samsung for budget-minded consumers. And actually, it's not an unlocked phone, so it's not like you just go buy this and then use it on any carrier. The one I'm using is by Total Wireless. You can find these guys in Walmart and probably Target and that sort of thing. So if you have a company that you deal with all the time, like AT&T, Verizon, and you're looking for an inexpensive phone, even though you can unlock this, there's a bit of a process. So in a lot of ways, this is really meant for a budget phone if you're going away somewhere and don't want to take your expensive phone, or if you have to give one to the kids, or something like that. You can get really inexpensive plans for it, so that's not really the point of the phone to add it to your existing account. So this particular model runs Android 6.0. So yeah, you're quite a ways back in Android land if you're jumping on this one. It's got a 5-inch 720p display. So again, you're not cutting edge, but you're only paying $50 to $60. Settle down. It's got 16 gigs of storage, a 5-megapixel shooter on the back, and a 2-megapixel shooter on the front. And yeah, that's good enough for just taking random pictures. I'll actually show you some samples a little bit later on. And of course, you can shoot 1080p video, which is very important. One other thing is the battery life is pretty good, 24 hours of talk time. But I mean, you're probably not gonna get 24 hours of talk time. Just understand that you can take this and use this all day and you'll be fine. So let's take a look at the phone itself. It's actually pretty cool. Down the one side, you can see the power button. Down the bottom, you have your micro USB and headphone jack. Still got a headphone jack. The other side, you can see your volume up and down, and at the top is pretty much nothing. On the front, you have your camera, you have your buttons at the bottom, your last, and your multi-app, and your camera on the back with a flash. I mean, it's a smartphone. Unlike a lot of smartphones today, the back is removable, the battery is removable, so if you run out of battery life, you can always just plop in another one, just buy an extra one. Also, it has a physical button. Now, I've missed these things since I used to have one on my Galaxy Note something or other. I don't even remember, it's been a while. And I love the tactile feel of a button. There's just something gratifying about pressing the button and knowing you're hitting it rather than just touching the screen. And one of the cool things about having a button is you can do the double tap and it goes right to the camera. That is phenomenal and totally a great feature. With current phones, there are other shortcuts, but man, just being able to quickly just double tap and then boom, camera time. So yeah, there's a little bit of bloatware on here, not a whole bunch, and certainly nothing that you can't live with or without. I will say though that the performance is really good. When I swipe through, I don't see really any lag. Bringing up the camera was pretty quick, and it's just a really good performing phone. And for most phones around this price range, they usually do pretty well. But this is Samsung and their quality has been pretty good. Now, one other thing you might have to worry about is a lot of Samsung phones over time do get slower. I've not encountered that with this, but you've been warned. Most people are gonna use this for social media or taking pictures on a trip. Here's some footage right here. As you can see, it's clean, it's clear, and even the pictures look good. And you know, for something like Snapchat or Instagram or whatever, this is gonna be more than enough. So again, it comes down to what are your needs? If you need something for travel or the kids or something like that, this is actually a great, great phone for that. It's very inexpensive, it's pretty hardy. I mean, listen, if you drop or lose it at 60 bucks, you know, just don't go to Starbucks for a week. Anyway, for the performance and price, I'm gonna say if you need something like this, this is not a bad way to go. So if this video helped you out in any way, hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, and share it to all your friends. And if it didn't, hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, and share it to all your friends. I'm here every single week having a blast doing this. Hope to see you again real soon. Peace and love, peace and love.